What's up, guys? It's Jeff Ray, featured guest host here with Weld.com. On today's episode, we have a viewer's request where they'd like to see some walk in the cup on a piece of 6-inch carbon steel Schedule 40 pipe. So let's get at it. On today's episode, we're gonna be welding this piece of 6-inch Schedule 40 carbon steel pipe. We're gonna go through the different techniques of walking the cup. When I'm putting the root in, as that cup walks down in the groove, and then as it fills up, and that technique will change, and then also putting a cap on this thing. So I've got it prepped and ready. I'm gonna go through tacking this thing, get the machine turned on and set up, and then we'll get this thing welded out. Now that everything's cleaned, beveled, and ready to tack, I just want to talk about my grinding process for a second. When creating this bevel here, you've seen I had a roll technique that I was using with the face of the grinder. It helps to be real proficient with learning that technique to be able to execute that perfect angle that we want on the bevels here. As you see, my degree finder shows 37.5 degrees, which is exactly what we want. And just from doing this over the years, I've become real proficient at being able to make nice clean bevels like this at the right degree. So these things are ready to tack now. Go ahead and get the machine turned on, go through my settings, get the root started in this thing. So let's get at it. Got the argon on. We're gonna be running 100% straight argon on this. The machine turned on. We're utilizing the Everlast Power TIG 210 EXT today. Machine's already set on DC. We're utilizing the foot pedal, high freak TIG start. Turn the amps up to about 92. That should be pretty good to start with. So let's get the hood on. We'll get this thing tacked together. Both pieces are prepped. Got a piece of 332 wire bent in a V that's gonna allow us to tack this. I'm gonna run a 332 gap. I've got a 1/16th landing on the face of this. Let's get it. So when you're tacking this stuff, with it being open like that, it's gonna wanna draw close. And usually when it draws close on my wire, I can usually just give it a tap and it'll pull out. That's not the case this time, so I had to feather the tack a little bit. There she goes. So we get two more tacks burned in here. Get this root laid in this thing. Got all the tacks made now. We're gonna go ahead and chuck it up here in the bench. Get this thing welded out. We'll start here. This tack that we've already got feathered down, bring it up. We're gonna quarter this thing. I'll talk about the techniques that I'm using while walking in the groove. Gonna use a number 9 torch with a number 7 gas lens cup on there. I want a smaller cup so it fits in the groove. Then as it starts to fill up and I have a bigger weave, I'll change to a bigger cup to help with that. From looking at my tacks, I need a little bit more heat. This pipe is pretty thick, so I'm gonna come over here, turn it up about 5-6 more amps. Get these things burned in here, get this root burned in. So we got the first root in there. I'm gonna go ahead and spin this thing. We're gonna quarter it out, get the next one put in there. Got those feathered down with a file there. Looks like I'm gonna need a little bit more heat. I haven't welded carbon steel pipe this big in a while, so I forget all my heat settings. I did burn through about half of it, but I do need a little bit more heat. So I like the smaller diameter cup. It lays in the groove better for a nice walk in there. It was catching a little bit. It was a little hiccupy, but that just happens sometimes. So it just takes some practice. You wanna be real loose. I take the torch and I wrap my hand under and around because I don't like the weight of this playing when I'm walking. So that's not the case. It's just catching a little bit on that edge there. Yeah, let's get this next root laid in there and see if we can burn it in a little better. It took me until the fourth quarter to really get this root burned in here real nice. It took me to getting up to 110 amps for it to burn in there. It takes practice to know your heats, what size gap you want in there, how well you can walk in the cup in that groove, or if you're gonna freehand it. In this case, we're walking it. So now we're gonna go ahead and start filling this thing up. The technique will change a little bit as it starts to fill up. That bottom of that cup will be resting on a flat plane and not just at the top edge of the groove there. We're gonna turn the heat up, get this hot pass burnt in there, probably turn it up to 130 or so. See how that flows, so let's get at it. Got the hot pass made, went really well. I think I know why my cup was hanging up so much on the edge to edge there, is I don't walk the cup a lot anymore. Until you start to really put some wear on this, and this thing's had some heat cycles through it, it'll really start to glide on there. So now that I've put a little bit of material on there and it's, you know, got worked on, it actually is walking a lot better. Now we're gonna go ahead and put the fill on there and flush this thing out. So I'm gonna put on the bigger cup. I've got a Jazzy 10 here that I'm gonna use. So we got our cup on there now. We got it changed out. We're ready to fill this thing out. It's gonna start to flush out and we're actually gonna be walking on the cup and not on those outer edges of the bevel. So we'll get this thing flushed out and then get it capped out. So let's get at it. We got the fill all filled up. Now we're ready for the cap. I don't have any more eighth inch wire, as well as I don't like using eighth inch wire when capping it out. It just takes too much heat to move the amount of material there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna utilize two pieces of 332 wire. It just flows a lot better for me. I got the machine turned up about 5 more amps just to help this thing really wet in there and flow really nice. Once I get done with the weld, I'll go into the technique a little bit more about what I'm looking for when walking the cup here. So let's get at it. We got this thing capped out now. It looks amazing. Flowed real nice. I want to talk about what I'm looking for when I'm capping this out. So the edge of the puddle here, where it wets into the pipe, that's all I'm watching, is the edge of that puddle falling to each side. I don't worry about the wire, how close my tungsten is, nothing like that. I've just learned that over time. So I'll just watch it fall to each side. And you can see pretty consistent, almost straight. If you get it really good and tight, that line will be straight and you won't have any little nubbies on the side there. But other than that, it looks great. If you're not used to walking the cup on a piece of pipe and not scooting in that groove and actually walking it, you can take a piece of tape and lay it on the pipe. Pipe's too hot to lay the tape on right now, but it'll actually show you the steps in it. So you can figure out how to do that and it'll actually leave those etches, which you can see it in the weld profile. It actually has a little, not groove cut in it, but you can see the etching that this just leaves from walking on top of that weld. And this is a good technique you can use to practice walking the cup. It's a little bit different than when the pipe is actually hot and the cup is on there. Things can be slipperier or not so slippery, but it just depends on how new the cup is and how new you are to it. Being comfortable and laxed in your arm, you can't put a lot of pressure in there or you'll slip. So just something to be aware of. That wraps it up on this episode of walking the cup on this piece of 6-inch carbon pipe. I hope some of these techniques and tips that I've shown you today could be of help. Let us know in the comments below some techniques or tips that you guys use on walking the cup. Until next time, head over to weld.com where you can get connected with us directly through the member section, or head over to the members forum where you can ask questions and our advisors will gladly help you. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.